Assalamu alaikum. This is lecture 6 or Mathematica. In this lecture we are defining and evaluating function. We totally focus on function and how we write a function in mathematics. Here is few line or the few statement. There are this one. Here we define some evaluating function. You people should be keep in your mind when we define any function, then you can't be used as capital letter, because capital letters are used for Mathematica functions. Here we want to write any function when we use the low letter expansion. Let's suppose here we use the small f and we want to define a function, then we use square bracket x and underscore and the bracket close. Here what is this one? This one is here. If you put this command on your Mathematica, then you get this result. It means this one is the f of x lower letter and the square bracket is close equal to x divide x square plus 1. This is the result. If we put any value of this, any value of, let's suppose we put this one f of 3, then we get the result is 3/10. This automatically put 3 in this function and we get the result. Same as if we want to compute any other result, we should use these the function, the variable and the underscore. Here you watch, we compute this one is n1 is this one, and here is we compute this one, the f of 3, the f is defined as you know before. This is the f. Here this function read this f from above. Here you watch on this simplification. This is in Mathematica. Here we write n1 backslash dot h approaches to 0. This mean evaluate n1 if b equal to 0. Here we says if the h approaches to 0. If you have lot of numbers, let's suppose here is a list of the number that you want to put in your function, and the function is defined before here, and we have not only 3, we have many more number on list of the number we want to choose and we want to put on this one and get their answer, then we write in this way. First of all we write to, if you we want to get this result in this list, here are some feature table f of n, and this one is n1 n2, return to the list, and this one. Here we watch on the few example about these tables. For more explanation, let's suppose this is the one clear edge. This is read before as we define this one. Let's move on this one. HT underscore of this, you know, this is we define any a function H of T. This one is 1 plus T whole power 1 over T, and we use the this bracket for together write 1 by T. Now if we put h of 1, it means we put the value of t equal to 1, we get the result is 2. See at this example, let's suppose we define a function that is f of 0 equal to 1 and f of 1 equal to 1, and this one is the f n the underscore and the square bracket, this is our defined function. Here we put first in place of 0. 0 mean we use n equal to 0 and f of 0 equal to 1, and we get the result. Same as we use this one. In next example, if we have a table of numbers, let's suppose this is a table in square bracket n, f of n, the bracket close, the n 0 to 10. Now write this one in this form, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. It means when we put 0 in place of t, we get 1. When we put n equal to 1, that table is understandable. You now we defined f of n, already defined here, f of n is defined. Here we write in table n and comma f of n, and the bracket is closed. And this one tells us we use n in place. First of all, we put 0 to 10. It means first we put 0 in place of n, then we put 1 in place of n, and 2, 3 up to goes to 10. And when we use 10, we get the result. Okay, viewer, this lecture is focused on how to write a function and how we put the values of different values of function in a single function. If we have a single value, then we can directly use that value. Here, first of all, we define that function and then we click f of 1 and shift plus enter, we get the result. If we have number of the number of values want to put in single function, then we use this rule, the table rule, and we get all of the result and their solution.